All right, my name is Lewis Knudsen, and this is Davenport Special Collections Sessions, brought to you by QC Beats. Submissions coming up this fall. I'm going to start off with a song I wrote called Home Is Where. I have been living in Chicago, and I moved to South Korea to teach English for a couple of years, and really got kind of I was spending a lot of time learning the language and hanging out with my Korean friends, and felt kind of almost started feeling rooted there, and then realized it wasn't going to be a whole life thing. So I came back to the U.S. and lo and behold, ended up staying in the Quad Cities where I had been mostly raised, and had this period when I came back where kind of just didn't feel like anywhere was really home because I had been moving around so much. And so I wrote this song.
Yeah.
Great. The next one is called Color and Warmth, and this is kind of a song without a real story behind it, but it's just a song about kind of textures and cozy feelings that make life better. Soften the light. Reds and oranges offset the white. Dark purple wind that blows through the window at night. Oh, 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 how this cold world. Watching graffiti while I wait for the train. Spilling coffee from a cup with a handwritten name. Breaking in my new white shirt with a stain. Tune my guitar here, and all these notes are so different from the normal tuning. It's gonna take a second, but while I am tuning, I will tell a kind of a story about the next song. Hopefully, the string doesn't break. nothing to build tension like talking about a string possibly breaking. I had this. Speaking of. When I came back to the Quad Cities, through a friend, I found out about a 2000 Buick Century that someone had just sitting around, and they were wanting to give it to someone, and so I was like, oh, me. So I got a free Century. It would have been 2011, so it was an 11-year-old car at the time. It had, I think, 90-something miles on it, but it was, you know, better than nothing. It was actually a really good car. But, you know, as the years went on, I was touring a lot. I was driving to gigs all the time, and probably could have been a little easier on the brakes. But it was a good car. But as with any good car, stuff started just going wrong with it. And I would have people in the car with me and say, oh, you know the gas light's on. Oh, no, that's just how it is. Like, I'm counting the mileage. You know, it's not actually low on gas. I just refilled it. And, yeah, this window doesn't work. Oh, yeah, it never works. I mean, why would you expect it to work? You know, that kind of thing. It had so many things going wrong with it that it just became very normal. And so finally, after a tour out to New York City and back, it was overheating. It was really stressing me out, the car was. And I was also I was also stressed out by the fact that I was trying to write and record one brand new song every single week. So anyway, with all the stuff going wrong with my car, I kind of started relating to it. I felt like this car is about to just break down, and that's how I feel too. So, but it's a little bit of kind of finding a lightheartedness in that too. So this one is called a Silver Century, and it's more or less a journal about a lot of the things that went wrong with my New York Century. Here we go. Gotta press a button a certain way to get the windows to roll down, and even then it may not work at all. Got pulled over for a headlight out, couldn't even roll the window down. I got a written warning that said it might be time to go car shopping. The engine overheated when I drive. Replace the radiator last July. Tires with the wires showing through. Tell me I'm living on borrowed time. The rear left window started slipping down. So I super glued it shut just before the winter came to town. That's right, I actually super glued my window, and it worked. Me and my silver century were mostly broken, but we keep on going. Me and my silver century were mostly broken, but we keep on going. Yeah, we keep on going. Already spent a lot fixing it. That new fuel pump cost me quite a bit. It's running for now. Gonna drive it right into the ground. The CD player only works when it wants. The bass notes rattle and it skips a lot. I'm trying to gather my scattered thoughts, but always coming to a four-way stop. I caught myself a break back in January. Then the river froze over. And it's been scary, been wondering for a while if I've just got too many miles. Me and my silver century, mostly broken, but we keep on going. Me and my silver century, mostly broken, but we keep on going. Yeah, we keep on going. The ashtray I used to charge my phone broke off during loading a year ago. I tried really hard to fix it, got really frustrated, and then said, skip it. I heard a sound that wasn't too good. Every time I hit a bump in the neighborhood, I looked underneath and I could tell the strut broke straight through the rusted wheel. Well, but it's been that way for 2 years now. Through the shows and the tours, and still somehow she goes, how she does, nobody knows. Me and my silver century were mostly broken. But we keep on going. Me and my silver century, mostly broken. Yeah, but we keep on going. Yeah, but we keep on going. ready. Thanks for joining me for this Davenport Special Collections session. I'm going to play a couple more songs. I was very honored to be included in the first round of QC Beats artists. And so here's the first couple songs I did were from that album, which is called Philip, that I wrote and recorded here in the Quad Cities. And this song is another one from it. It's called Be in the Time. That was Be in the Time from my Philip album. I'm going to play one more song also from that Philip album that's on the QC Beats catalog. This one's called Slow Lane. I was doing some live streams during March and April, and May and June. And this is a song that a lot of people were kind of able to relate to as they were just sitting at home and sheltering and quarantining. It's called Slow Lane. Used to really want to be a big star on TV. Well, that did not work out, obviously. I made up my mind, I'm not gonna even try. If I'm not racing, then you can't say you beat me. Just as soon stay in the slow lane. 50 and a 65, gonna stay in the slow lane. It's enough to survive, gonna stay in the slow lane. Slow lane, and enjoy my time. These days by 3, I'm feeling so much lethargy. I just wanna stay at home and watch TV. I see no silver lining in winning second place, so I withdraw my name in order to save face. Just as soon stay in the slow lane. 50 and the 65, gonna stay in the slow lane. It's enough to survive, gonna stay in the slow lane, slow lane, and enjoy my time. Angel shall catch you, you won't strike your foot against a stone, no. You won't strike your foot against a stone. No. I don't care to state my views, there are too many sides, unproven manuscripts and blind guides. I have no opinion, my own personal decree is that everyone in the world must agree that no one knows for sure, just like me, just like me, just like me, just like me in the slow lane. Yeah, 50 and the 65, gonna stay in the slow lane. It's enough to survive, gonna stay in the slow lane, slow lane, and enjoy my. Once again, this has been Davenport Special Collections Sessions. My name is Lewis Knudsen, and thanks for watching.